Hey everyone, it's Zinnia here from OctoStudio, and today I wanted to show you how to make a clicker game or an idle game on the phone. This will be a two-part series. Here in part one, I'll show you how to add a clickable item and how to draw a shop. And then in part two, I'll show you how to make the player be able to purchase items from the shop for upgrades. So yeah, let's get started.
So I will just tap on Create New Project, and I'll tap Choose a Sprite. And then here you can choose what you want the clickable item in your game to be. And, you know, it really just depends. What do you want the theme of your clicker game to be? You know, you could have like a turtle clicker game or a house clicker game. I think I'm gonna do a cupcake themed clicker game. So I will tap on the cupcake and then you can just choose whatever backdrop you want. I'm gonna pick this blue one. And to start out, let's make it so that when we tap on this cupcake, it plays a sound and we get a point. So to do that, I'm gonna go to the words and sounds category and just drag out a play sound block. And we can test this out by tapping on it. So it plays that sound. You could also tap on the name of the sound if you want to and tap this button to choose really any sound you want. I think I'm gonna choose this click sound for my game. So now it'll play that. I'll make it play this every time that I tap on the cupcake. So I can do that by going to the when to start category and dragging out this when I tap block and putting it on top. And so now every time I tap on the cupcake, it plays the sound. Now to make the player get a point every time they tap on the cupcake, I'll go to the more blocks category and I can drag out this block that says change. And then when you drag it out, it'll say change variable score. And if you attach it there, now what will happen is when you tap on the cupcake, this variable score will increase by one. And a variable in OctoStudio just keeps track of a certain number in your project. And in these clicker games, the player is usually tapping on some item to make a variable go up. And you can choose what you want the variable to be called in your game. I think in my game, I will call it cupcakes. So I can just tap here and tap the plus sign and add a new variable called cupcakes. Oh, and one thing I should fix is right now when you tap the play button and then you tap on the cupcake again, the cupcake's value, you know, it starts really high. So what I'll do is I'm going to set the variable cupcakes to zero every time the player restarts the game. And I can do that by dragging out a when play block and putting it on top. And to make the click even more satisfying, I'm gonna have the cupcake do a little growing and shrinking animation. So I could do that by going to the scene category. And if you drag out the change size block, that makes it increase the size a little bit. And actually, if you drag out another one and change size by negative 20, that will make the size go down. So if I attach these blocks together and attach that here under this code, then now when I tap it, it does a little, change size. Now, one issue with this is that if you keep tapping it, you'll get a very large cupcake, which maybe you want that for your game and you can keep it that way. But if you do want to make it go back to being small, you can drag out this set size block and type in a number to set the size back to. So I'm gonna set the size to 100. And now if I tap that, it makes it return to its regular size. So I can put this code under here. And now if I tap the cupcake and it gets very big, eventually it will get smaller again. It's pretty fun though.
Next, let me show you how to design a shop sprite and how to draw an item to go in the shop. And in part two of this series, I'll show how to make the player be able to click on that item and purchase it. For now, let's get started with drawing the shop. So I'm going to paint a new sprite, and I can do that by tapping here to add a sprite, and I'll tap paint. And for my shop, I'm gonna just do a really simply draw a rectangle and write shop at the top. You could obviously draw more if you'd like, but if you wanna just do a rectangle and some text, the way you can do that is I'll tap on this color and make the rectangle be black for my game, and I will drag it out. And then I'll tap on the text tool, and here I'm gonna set the color to white, and I'm just gonna write shop. Pretty nice. And I'll accept that to see how that's looking. I think that's pretty good. I'll make it a little bit bigger. And I'll move the cupcake, if it'll let me. I'm gonna try to move this cupcake to the side. Perfect. Now, let me show you how to add an item to the shop. So I will tap on add a sprite again, and here is where you can choose, you know, what you want the first purchasable item in your game to be. And as before, you know, you can pick any type of item that you want for the theme of your game. I think since I have a cupcake clicker, I'll make the first item be a spoon for making the cupcakes. And so you can put that item in the shop. Let me make that smaller. Oh, I made the shop smaller. There we go. And I want this spoon to have some text that says how much it costs. So to add that, I'm just gonna tap to expand this little menu and then tap the pencil to edit the sprite. And I will move this to the side a bit with the selection. And I will tap on the text and write out in white text, cost equals 10, except you completely can't see it. So I will make a black rectangle behind all of this so that, you know, we can actually see the text. I'm gonna click on select on this select tool and just send it to the back layer. And if I tap accept, now you can see, since the black background is the same color as the black background of our shop, you know, you don't actually see it here. You just see our lovely little spoon. So that is how you can draw a shop and an item. And yes, stay tuned for part 2, where I will show how to make the player be able to buy these upgrades from the shop and how to make the upgrades give the player more and more points. So yeah, I hope you enjoy, and I will see you in the next video.